Hi everybody, welcome back to Becoming Miss. My name is Nerina Lesekhomaleke, but you can certainly call me Lily, and I am the captain of this ship.
When I popped off, then your girl gave me just a little bit of lacha, baby, so cool.
So in today's episode, I'm going to be talking about Miss World 2021. I am so excited about this because my number one spot is going to go to my most favorite contestant. But you guys are going to find out later on, and you have to watch till the end to find out who this wonderful contestant is going to be. And I truly, truly have faith in her. And unlike the last list that I made for Miss Universe, this time it is putting this country at the top. And we're debating about this, like who's gonna get the top spot. If you haven't checked out that video, I'm gonna link it to the description. I'm also gonna link it right there on your info notes. So yeah, you're not gonna miss out. Make sure you stay connected, stay linked. Firstly, before I even get into my video, I want to encourage you all to please subscribe to my channel. Let me warn you, there's low shedding, so my sound quality might be poor, my lighting might be poor. I apologize for that,
but I had to deliver this baby. I had to deliver this baby, or else it was gonna die in my uterus. I'm telling you, it was gonna be so bad, it was gonna be a disaster.
My Miss World top 20. I feel like Miss World has a lot of very nice, very flamboyant, very fragrant and fresh new voices and fresh new faces. I feel like I'm loving the energy. The energy is superb. It's beautiful. The ladies are beautiful. They're bringing this energy, this aroma, this scent. I am so, like, I am willing to indulge. My eyes are ready to watch. Usually I'm not a person who would be like sitting around. Miss World is not really, but I feel like the competition this year is just on another level, and I'm loving the fact that it is happening like this, and it really makes me so excited. And if you have any favorites, or should you not agree with the list, please let me know in the comment sections. We're gonna start from number 20 right up to your golden number one. Number 20 has to go to Bolivia. My number 19 is the USA. I am so sorry that I have to put Miss USA at the end of the list, but like I said, that USA used to be like really competitive in terms of the pageant world, but I feel like lately USA really needs to bring us that energy they're really lacking. And they I feel like there's a lot of training they need to do, they need to focus more. And I feel like the attention from the pageant world has kind of shifted in such a way it left them lacking and lagging behind. And I don't know, it's just my opinion. What do you think? Do you think USA has been delivering the way they used to in the past? I feel like USA is kind of like, but that's just me. What do I know? I don't know nothing. All I know is that my number 18 is Costa Rica. My number 17 has to be Japan. My number 16, Panama. Number 15, Rwanda. Number 14, Cameroon. Number 13, Nicaragua. Oh my god, I am so sorry to the Nicaraguans, because I always seem to get your pronunciation of your country incorrect. Please help me out. How do you... My South African accent is fighting. It's like, no, you will never be able to sing. I apologize. Let us continue. Number 12, Spain. Number 11, Czech Republic. Number 10. But before I can go into the top 10, how are you liking the list so far? Are you still here? Are you still watching? Are you hungry for that number 10? You want to know who's in the top 10? There are no guarantees. What I always say is that in the pageant, it's any girl's game. The game can always change and there's still time. So this time in between, these ladies can use it to work on themselves. They can come back better and more ready to fight. The ladies, especially at the bottom of the list, can come back stronger. So there are no guarantees. But, nah. Listen to this, there are no guarantees, but the ladies on my list are definitely the top contestant, and I can bet that our Miss World 2021 is 99.9% going to come from this list. But there's that 1%, that 0.1% that she might not, but I really trust the fact that I have really looked into it, and I really believe that this is it, you know. But that doesn't mean that because you're at number 20 you might not win, but it means you are also a very strong contender. And with all this time in between before the staging date, anything can happen. Absolutely anything can happen. The possibilities are limitless. Now we're going into the big top 10. These are the big guns. They got us by the let's get into it. So my number 10 sport, the first country to go into number 10. I know y'all is like, I hope it's not my country. I hope my country's at number one. But they're gonna be at number 10. And they are Tanzania. Tanzania is really, 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 I'm so happy that there's actually an African country in the top 10, because oh man, Africa and pageants, what are you guys doing? That is none of my business, but I feel like Africa really, 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 oh man, let us move on. Number 9, Belgium. Number 8, Ecuador. Number 7, Vietnam. Number 6, Poland. Number 5, Slovakia. Number 4, Canada.
Did you know Justin Bieber is from Canada? Yeah, I used to be a Bieber back in the day, but...
Where was I? Was in number 3. So this is the top 3. This is the moment of truth. These ladies are on the podium. My mom was always like, yay, didn't make it to the podium. You know, top 3, you know, first, second princess, you know, queen is there. You know, these ladies in the top 3, they always have a chance and always like hoping, like, I really hope the queen falls and breaks and so that I can take that crown. Top 3. Now I'm really excited about this top 3. So far, I think the list is coming together really nicely, and I really, really, really want to know what you're thinking. So please do drop me a comment. Let me know what you're thinking. Who is on your list? Who's your top 20? Who's your top 10? Who's your top 5? Who's your top 3? Drop me a comment and let me know. Top 3. Miss World 2021. Who is on the podium? In my case, in my opinion, before I get into that, I would really, really appreciate your thumbs up, a comment, and a subscription. Now turn on your post notifications to make sure you get this content, this good content that you've been watching for about like 8 minutes now. You wanna get it on time and you wanna get fresh, make sure you turn on your post notifications so that you never miss out. Now let's get into the top 3, guys. I know I am wasting your time and you're like, I'm gonna fast forward you. Next. I'm gonna skip you by 10 seconds. Don't skip, okay? So this is the moment of truth, the moment you've been waiting for, the moment I've been dragging towards our top 3. And I've also changed the position for this because it's a special moment. I feel like it's special, and yeah, you're gonna find out my lucky number 1. Like I said, I promised you it's gonna be huge, it's gonna be big, it's gonna surprise you. So my number 3 has to go to Venezuela. Number 2, now you definitely hoping that she breaks her neck so you can be. Indonesia has to be my number 2, and my lucky number 1, our queen, our Miss World 2021, definitely a deserving contestant, a very strong contestant from a powerhouse in Africa. Now if you heard powerhouse and pageant and Africa in one sentence, is definitely going to be South Africa. So my number 1 is South Africa, definitely Shudufatso Msida, our queen, you know, our all hail our Miss South Africa 2020. She is beautiful, she's amazing, she's everything. I think she's definitely going to give us what we are looking for. It's been a long drought, seriously, since Rollins draws. South Africa has not won Miss World. That was like 7 years ago. Seriously, like, come on. And I think that South Africa's strategy, although I feel like it was a bit, you know, we can, you know, but I think the decision to swap the contest and take one to Miss World, take one to Miss Universe was definitely a very good and strategic move. That is something that would take an entire episode to discuss. So if you really want to have that conversation, and if you really would like to hear why Natasha is going to Miss Universe, whereas she's the second runner-up, you know, out there hoping, like, I hope PewDiePie breaks and so I can go to Miss Universe. But someone out there decided, you know what, I'm gonna make it happen for her. I'm gonna make it so easy. I'm gonna type that. Hey, Shudu, Miss World. And I think she... Okay, I'm sorry, guys. I'm such a clown. If you are willing to have that discussion, you really want to hear my opinion on that matter and that subject, please do drop me a comment, and I'm definitely going to make it happen, because I am here to serve. You know, I serve. I deliver. I make sure things happen. I get the things done. But I definitely believe in Shudu Fazo, and I have so much faith in her. She's a queen. She's beautiful, and she's really, really, she got that eccentric energy that is so vital in Miss World. Miss World is looking for someone vibrant. She's well-spoken, and she's got everything. She's just like a fun, bubbly, wholesomeness. She's like a bun in Okay, this has been fun, but unfortunately we have come to the end of our episode, and this has been really exciting. This has been an interesting list for me to compile, and I really, really had so much fun. It took me about 2 weeks to come up with this list, but I really, really think that these are our bullets, and I think that our South African Miss South Africa, wow, she is coming for the throne. She is coming, and if with enough work, like, you know, and we have calculated the whole something, anything, it's any girl's game, she's definitely in the gang. And yeah, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope by now you have subscribed, you have liked the video, and you have definitely shared. Oh, you're about to share. Come on, I can see your little fingers about to click it. Make sure you subscribe, make sure you share the video, make sure you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and definitely do drop me a comment. I love comments, and I'm gonna go around, I reply where there's a need for reply. Give me something to interact with, and I'm definitely gonna interact with you. And thank you all so much for tuning in. This is me, Nerina Lesego Maluleke, signing out. Yeah, I am the one. Queen is out.